Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, DwyerVIP.com. Look us up in the sports section online on Roku. We're there, Dwyer Boxing and Sports News. Vanity code to add it on the Roku site, one word, Dwyer Boxing News. Same on iTunes. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, yesterday the stars aligned and you had a very special moment, a great moment for the sport of boxing. One of the very best, if not the best, boxing commentator in the game, former champion Paulie Malignaggi, happened to be doing the Amir Khan Devin Alexander fight for Showtime. Now, I usually watch a British feed for these championship fights. Sometimes I'll watch a feed from places like Russia or Turkey or somewhere in Eastern Europe, right? But I made sure to watch the Showtime feed for this fight because I understood that Malignaggi's at the top of the game. And just by chance, just because the stars aligned, Malignaggi had actually been in the ring with Amir Khan, right? For those who don't recall it, Malignaggi got KO'd in the 11th round. Up until that point, Malignaggi had never truly been stopped in a fight in his boxing career. Buddy McGirt in his corner threw in the towel a bit prematurely. In his fight against Ricky Hatton, understand Malignaggi was a guy who got a broken jaw and still went the distance against Miguel Cotto, right? Let's just say Malignaggi was so upset with Buddy McGirt tossing in the towel on his fight with Ricky Hatton that he and McGirt split up, right? There was acrimony. Google Malignaggi's comments about Buddy McGirt after the end of his fight with Ricky Hatton. So when he was in the ring against Amir Khan, in Paulie Malignaggi's mind, he had never been stopped. This is before Sean Porter years later, right? And just understand, he was overwhelmed in that fight, right? For the truly hardcore, I believe I even did a prediction video on that fight years ago when I was just starting out here on YouTube, at least early on in this YouTube run, right? So what you had really was a great commentator with insider knowledge. And understand, Malignaggi is a guy who is strong enough to let you know what he thinks even when he's the only one in the room who thinks it. Now, let me say, understand who Malignaggi was as a fighter. I should say is, his career might still be ongoing. Understand that Malignaggi was hard to hit. Understand that Malignaggi was slick. Understand that Malignaggi could move around the ring. Malignaggi was a guy who had the boldness to keep his hands down, even against a jabber like Shevchenko, and to use his upper body to dodge punches. Right? So you're talking about a guy who was an above average fighter, who wasn't a brawler, who was a technician. And what Malignaggi had to say on the telecast was that even for him, a guy with an above average jab, with above average hand speed, even for him, Amir Khan was simply too fast. And what Malignaggi said next was fascinating. He said at times it looked like Khan was just moving his hands in front of you. The punches didn't have that much sting on them. But then, in the middle of the combination. Amir Khan would then drop a shot to the body that would have Sting. Right? The problem with hand speed is it's like Russian roulette. The guy's throwing a flurry, you think, oh, these are a bunch of arm punches, then boom, you get hit with something real. Something that hurts. The kind of punch that, for example, put Marcus Maidana down. Right? Understand, Amir Khan has power. As you're looking at all the hand speed, understand there's some pop behind the punches and the combination that he wants to throw. So then what Malignaggi would later say was fascinating. He said, you know, really, to deal with Amir Khan, you can't wait for him to throw. You have to throw with him. That's how fast he is. Now understand, boxing is rock, paper, scissors. Floyd Mayweather is really the premier counterpuncher in the sport. But at a certain speed of opposition, right? If your opponent is too fast, if the hand speed is too blinding, then let me ask, what are you going to counter? Understand, if a counterpuncher is forced to throw with Amir Khan, when Amir Khan is throwing punches, just to land punches, that's going to take the counterpuncher out of his game. Now let me briefly talk about the Devin Alexander fight. There's really not much to say. What I want to assure YouTube Nation of, and I know it's an open question today, but let me assure you that Devin Alexander has hand speed that's well above average. He has very good hand speed. Right? He's fast. Marcus Maidana, after he lost to Devin Alexander, said that he was fast and he was a southpaw and gave him problems. Right? Alexander's so fast, he can simply use hand speed to overwhelm an opponent like Marcus Maidana. Now, I say that because as you looked at this bout, Alexander looked slow, didn't he? Amir Khan's hand speed was so blinding at times that it didn't even look like Alexander was in the slow lane. It actually looked like Alexander was parked on the side of the road. Right? This was really a hand speed exhibition. I have to tell you, relatively early on in this fight, I stopped scoring it. Because it was obvious to me that if Alexander couldn't hit Amir Khan's fastball, then he would need a knockout to win the fight. And let's just say this was before on Showtime when they went to Steve Farhood and they said, what's your scorecard after six? Farhood said, 6-0. Amir Khan. Right? Khan, let me say this too. It needs to be said. There is a trade-off. Khan under Virgil Hunter. And understand, Khan is working with the trainer for Andre Ward. Right? Under Virgil Hunter, Amir Khan is much more balanced than he is, or than he was, under Freddie Roach. Right? When Khan comes in, he doesn't seem as off balance as he did with Roach. Right? He comes in, he seems to be even keel. And understand, Khan throws hard punches with both hands. He's a righty, but he has an excellent left hook. Right? But there's a trade-off. Because understand, with Freddie Roach, while Khan was more off balance, Khan was also more sudden. In other words, if you look at the Zab Judah fight, and I know Judah was at the fight last night, right? Zab Judah looks baffled, not just with Khan's hand speed. And keep in mind, Judah, even today, has some of the fastest hands in the sport. But Judah was absolutely baffled by Khan's entry point. In other words, Khan under Roach was more of an ambush fighter. Right, he'd be outside, then suddenly he's inside. It's like a horror flick, as I like to say, right? Suddenly the zombie's right up on you, right? Somehow the zombie, who was way across the yard when you last looked at him, is now inches away from you. Only, in this case with Khan, he's throwing a lightning-fast combination. Then he would jump back out, right? But Khan looked clumsy doing it. You remember the Paul McCluskey fight? Now, this version of Khan's a little bit different. Khan's closer to the pocket, right? He's even keel. He's really relying on angles now to beat you, not being so far away then jumping in or hiding behind a jab. Now he's coming in, but he always seems to be off over your shoulder, right? I believe this makes him even deadlier, because Khan seems to be able to adjust his punches based on what he's seeing. Right? So it's interesting here, because he has the fight with Devin Alexander in the bag. Certainly by the start of the ninth round, the fight's over, apart from Alexander possibly needing a knockout to win the fight. I mean, you know, the last three rounds of this fight are just 9 minutes of looking at it, wondering if Alexander is going to be able to get a knockdown of Khan to get back in the fight. But curiously enough, Khan's still hovering on the outskirts of the pocket. Right? And I'll just say this. Devin Alexander had problems landing meaningful shots. Al Bernstein points out that Devin Alexander had a very hard time landing his right hook, which is a trademark punch of his. Right? Alexander has a great uppercut. Look at the Juan Urango fight. For some reason, he couldn't pull the trigger on it because Khan kept moving. Right? Let me say this too. Whoever came up with the idea of Amir Khan wearing white gloves in the ring is a genius. That's a brilliant move. If I'm Amir Khan, I never wear gloves of any other color. Because with his level of hand speed, the white gloves draw attention to what he's doing in the ring. You're looking at it and you're seeing all this white, and it's moving too fast, and it's bouncing off Devin Alexander's face. And you understand, wow, this is different, right? The red gloves kind of hides the hand speed a little bit. The white gloves frames it. Let's just say it was all working for Amir Khan against Devin Alexander, right? I didn't see a round that I gave to Alexander. That's how dominant the performance was, right? The only guy who may have had a better night was Paulie Malignaggi from the booth, right? Now, let me say this. For a very long time here online, certainly several months, I've been, even when Khan was down on his luck, I've been talking about how, in my opinion, Amir Khan is one of the scariest opponents for Floyd Mayweather, right? There's only an inch difference in height between Khan and Devin Alexander, right? Only an inch difference in height. But the way Khan fights gives the illusion of him being much taller. He's a master at using length. He's a master at it, right? He doesn't seem to have to get close to you to hit you. And as he moves around the ring, it looks like his opponent has to reach to hit him. He has faster hand speed than Floyd Mayweather. Now, Floyd's been at a hand speed disadvantage in other fights. I encourage you to look at the hand speed gap in the first three rounds of his fight against Zab Judah. But understand here, it's pretty severe, right? And understand Amir Khan marries that hand speed with foot speed. Now, Paulie Malignaggi on the telecast, a guy who, unlike me, has actually been in the ring with Amir Khan, openly talked about how he thought Amir Khan would give Floyd Mayweather a very hard time. This is an actual Khan opponent, right? Al Bernstein actually ends up agreeing with Malignaggi. Because keep in mind, Amir Khan, he's fast. He hits what's open. Your body's open, he's able to hit it. Your head's open, he's able to hit it. Understand you're talking about a two-handed attack from a guy who knows how to use length. Now, I know if you research the heights on Mayweather and Khan, you're going to find that they're practically the same height. I'm telling you, in the ring, as Mayweather bends from the waist, Khan jumping around is gonna look taller. He's certainly gonna look faster. Now, let me say this too. People who know boxing a lot better than I do. Former cruiserweight champion Johnny Nelson, the British commentator, who, like Malignaggi, is one of the best in the sport, right? He believes Amir Khan's style would make him a tough opponent for Floyd Mayweather. Now, let me say this. Let me back out a second here, because you know where I'm going with this. I believe the toughest fight Floyd has had over the last several years isn't the first Marcus Maidana fight. Give me a break. It was his fight against Miguel Cotto. Right? That's the one fight that Floyd's face actually looked a little bit swollen after. Understand, Cotto right now is bigger than he's ever been physically, right? He's the middleweight champion, and he's with Freddie Roach, and his game has lifted a notch. This isn't the same Cotto who lost to Austin Trout. So let me say this. In my opinion, two of the toughest guys for Mayweather to fight would be Amir Khan. Don't believe me. Listen to Paulie Malignaggi on the broadcast yesterday. Google the comments of former cruiserweight champ Johnny Nelson. Understand, these aren't loons out there trying to sell tickets. No, these are former champions who've seen and been in several championship fights. Right? Now, I'm just here to tell you, Miguel Cotto, don't get me wrong, I think Floyd beats Cotto. I think Floyd would have an edge on Cotto. I don't know if Floyd would have an edge on Amir Khan. Right? But I will say, Floyd has two fights left. In my book, those guys would be worthy opponents. Now, what I'm going to say next is probably going to be what this video is remembered for. But let me say this. At this point, the torch has passed. Right? In my opinion, and I know YouTube Nation disagrees with me, but if Floyd's next fight is against Manny Pacquiao, let's just say I believe Floyd is again calling out Pacquiao because he understands there are more dangerous fish in the water. Right? Why call out Pacquiao and why say, hey, let's do it in May? Let's do it on Showtime? Because Floyd knows the fans want it. But I believe Floyd also knows that Amir Khan is a much tougher opponent than Manny Pacquiao. And that this version of Miguel Cotto is a much tougher opponent than Manny Pacquiao. Right? Understand, Manny Pacquiao was dropped by Juan Manuel Marquez. Right? Understand, that first fight against Timothy Bradley goes the distance. In fact, look at Pacquiao's resume. A lot of Pacquiao's fights have gone the distance. Well, as you look at the film of yesterday's fight involving Amir Khan, just ask yourself, right? Is Amir Khan's left hand more dangerous than Manny Pacquiao's right hand? You're going to notice times in this fight where Amir Khan just throws a left hook and they land, folks. They land. That's Khan's offhand. We know his right's legit. That's Khan's offhand. Just ask yourself. Is Amir Khan's length going to pose a challenge for Floyd Mayweather? Going to create problems for Floyd Mayweather that Manny Pacquiao's lack of length wouldn't create? Right? Khan is fast, blinding hand speed. Khan is in his 20s. He's younger than Manny Pacquiao. He still has the legs of a 20-year-old, right? He just took apart one of the better fighters at 147 pounds, and he did so by shutout. As you're watching this, do you believe Manny Pacquiao would have the margin of victory over Devin Alexander that Amir Khan just had? Right? I believe Floyd, I know the world thinks Floyd's ducking Manny, right? Even after offering him $40 million and now recently calling him out. I believe there's a group out there, and put me among them, right? A group that involves people like Johnny Nelson, people like Paulie Malignaggi, who now suspect that Floyd, by calling out Manny Pacquiao, is actually ducking Amir Khan, right? I encourage you to look at a replay of this fight. I'm telling you the things that would give Mayweather problems, right? Khan's two-handed hand speed. Khan's ability to hurt you with either hand from distance. Khan's length, right? Khan's youth. I'm just here to say that, you know, those things make Khan more dangerous an opponent for Floyd's style than Manny Pacquiao right now. You know, really, the torch has passed in terms of Freddie Roach disciples, right? Khan used to train with Freddie Roach. I understand Khan used to spar with Manny Pacquiao, right? But understand, boxing's a young man's game. In my opinion, the torch has passed from Manny Pacquiao to Amir Khan. An argument can be made that the torch has passed from Floyd Mayweather to Amir Khan and Keith Thurman. We'll find that out in time if Mayweather gets in the ring with either. I think Mayweather's too smart for that. I think Mayweather is calling out Pacquiao because he understands the water is more turbulent with Khan and Keith Thurman. Let me say this about Keith Thurman. I don't know what the crowd was booing for. I thought that was a masterful fight. A guy who hits as hard as Keith Thurman, who's that adept on his back foot, who's able to use foot speed, foot movement, to keep a guy on his front foot like Leonard Bundu unable to get close enough to hit him, that's a masterful performance. Thurman's a scary fighter, right? The young lions are at the gate. Not surprisingly, Floyd Mayweather is calling out a guy in his mid-30s, right, who has lost two recent fights, right? One by KO, not TKO, KO, right? Who doesn't have the length or the two-handed attack of Amir Khan, right? I know that's what casual fight fans want. I've heard you, YouTube Nation, you want Mayweather versus Pacquiao. Understood. Message delivered, right? They're bigger young lions in the forest right now, right? I'm guessing Mayweather looked at yesterday's Khan fight, turned to his representatives and said, "Al, please make that fight with Pacquiao happen." Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com and just tell me. I'm just curious here. If you feel Mayweather has the secret sauce to beat Amir Khan, right? Tell us what you believe that sauce is. Because the problem is this: Mayweather's a counterpuncher. How do you counter speed like this? I will agree, Khan is a guy who looks at you and is keying off of what you do. Now, I'll agree that a Danny Garcia, who, you know, in basketball they have no-look passes, in boxing you have no-look punches, right? A Danny Garcia is able to look away when he throws punches, and I believe that throws a guy like Amir Khan off, right? It's possible Floyd could do moves where he's looking away and throwing punches. My point to you, though, is that's not his game, right? I'm not saying that Khan is, you know, intrinsically better than Mayweather. All I'm saying is boxing's rock, paper, scissors, right? This seems to be, to me, a style that would give Mayweather a hard time. Don't believe me. Believe a former champion who's been in the ring with Amir Khan, Paulie Malignaggi. I hope you listen to his comments on the telecast. Thanks for stopping by.